Hello and welcome back for another clarinet tutorial from Nottingham Music Excellence. Now you could call this piece, I think, the perfect grade 8 piece. You know, it's quite concise, it's got lots of technical challenge in there, it's quite tricky to fit with the accompaniment in places, and both boards, the Trinity syllabus and the ABRSM syllabus, are both in agreement that this is a grade 8 standard. So I think this is a really super piece to play. And one of the things with playing this, you know, I know when I do this with my pupils, I can't play the piano part, you know, so it's often hard to get enough rehearsal time with the piano. So what I've done, I've uploaded two versions of the piano accompaniment, and on the steady version, on the slightly slower version, I've painstakingly inserted metronome clicks on the beat on that first page and on the final section, just to help you sort of synchronize with the piano and get used to hearing those sort of those stabs and those random chords out on the piano, and just get used to hearing that. And then hopefully you will, you know, when you come to prepare playing it for exam, it will, you know, you'll be just so much more comfortable at playing with the piano part. So hope you enjoy the tutorial. As usual, I'm going to play the piece, do a short tutorial on the detail of the music, and then you can get a chance to play along with the accompaniment yourself. And as always, the timestamps are in the description. So, hope you enjoy the video. Here we go. Okay, so you've heard the music. Let's now have a look at the notes and some of the detail and see if we can make this sound really awesome. So just on the opening line, one thing I always hear when I hear pupils have a go at this for the first time is they play it like this. They go, And it just sounds so classical, you know. So just be watch that. It's marked with accents and it's molto moccato. But I think in real terms, you know, to make it sound punchy, and it's quite fast, isn't it? So I think you've got to just play it staccato. So play those quavers quite staccato. So nice and punchy, you know. So yes, the accents are there, but make sure the notes are nice and short and rhythmic. And then we're moving on to this on the third bar. I've actually been doing this fingering with my son a couple of days ago, actually, on the E minor. It's kind of like an E minor harmonic fingering, isn't it? So if you go right hand B, left hand C, and then over to that D sharp. So it's a kind of a more technical extension of that, isn't it, really? And a good, and make sure those semiquavers that lead to that crotchet, ba-bam, you know, really tongue that, fit that semiquaver in nice and late. Not late, should I say, but, you know, nice and tidy. Okay, another thing that I always hear on this second line, when pupils play it, it like goes, you know, there's just a whole fistful of scramble of notes going down there. So I think when you're in the early stages of practicing this, really kind of just go from the C and play. Again, it comes down to that, putting that groundwork in there, putting that slow, you know, kind of slow practice in there. So forget about the Allegro Con Brio. When you're in the early stages of practicing it, you know, just take it down to like andante or something, you know, and really just build it up bit by bit. And really think da 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 da. Really play it beat by beat, and make sure it's just absolutely perfect at that speed before you try and speed it up. So. And really aim for that open G there on the. So. And then we're back into our kind of E minor harmonic fingering. Another thing to watch out for as well, just be careful. Some of the jumps up to the notes are ba-bum, and some of them are bum-bum. Some of them are a quaver, not a semi-quaver, like I've just played there. So be careful with that. But then you're back into the semi-quaver jumps again. So just be careful of that. It does need to be right. You know, you can't just kind of guess and play them all the same. And then you've got on the piano part, a bit of an easier part to follow. The piano goes, and you've just got this nice little arpeggio. Again, sort of hit the beat there really nicely. And then we've got this PP idea, so really come down and just sort of point out those accented notes. And I think don't be afraid there to play as quiet as you can possibly play, you know, because the piano's then going to come in and go bang, bang, da 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 dum, and then you're in fortissimo. So really get those massive contrasts of dynamics in the music there. So piano's got the stabby notes, and then you've got one. So big sound there, and then you're back to this punchy da-da, 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 da-da. But notice the first one is a quaver, not a semi-quaver. So.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, first, what you might call, not the first technically tricky bit, but certainly one of the bits that does catch people out. You could practice this in all sorts of ways, couldn't you? You could play. And then the other way around. Things like that, and then put it back to standard semiquavers again. Again, don't practice it too fast, too soon. Make sure you put that groundwork in there if you want to play it really, really nicely. And remember, of course, just keep those fingers really nice and close to the keywork. Make sure you've got a good hand position. You probably have by grade 8, hopefully. Make sure you're allowing, you know, I always teach my pupils to make sure you've got a bit of space in here in the hand so that the fingers reach at finger length, so you're not kind of all crunched upon the keys. Hopefully that's not a problem by grade 8, but you know, want to be nice and free with that hand. So you've got to keep that nice and flexible. So let's do some jazz, shall we? Now this is the fun part of the piece, isn't it? It should be the easier part. Having said that, it's not, you might say it's easier than the spiky stuff, you know, on the first page, but you don't really get anywhere to breathe in this page, do you? I always find that by the time I get down to the semiquavers, at bar sort of 40 and 50, I'm just dying for a breath, you know, and you don't really get anywhere to, you're just clutching at straws, you know, you're just really trying to hard to snatch a bit of breath somewhere in there. Anyway, so. So I think the key point on this, remember that the main tune is the notes that you see. So that has got to be, try not to detract from that too much. Don't let the grace notes interfere with that. Just kind of just fit them in, you know, as timeless notes. So you can still get that tune the way you want it. Slightly fiddly, I think the first one is slightly easier than going to the C, but this one, especially if you're going to do the proper fingering for the D and you're going to play C, C sharp, and then hit that little finger on the D to get a nice tuning on the D. Again, the D is the most important note because that's on the beat and that's, you know, that's your main tune, isn't it? And I think try and emphasize where the beats are so you can really hear that it changes like from a compound time to a 4-4 to a compound time and just play with that a little bit and accentuate it and make it, you know, make it really obvious that that we're, you know, kind of playing around with the time signatures. Now this is the point here when you get to the 4-4 at 47-48, you will be dying for a breath. So if you've played all that section 40 as it's written, you will be dying for a breath here, and it's just asking you to now play fortissimo with no rest. So how do you do it? I don't think I've got any clear-cut answers to that, to be honest. You've just got to really snatch little bits in as and when you can. So it'll be. I think that is the place for the breath, but you just haven't got long, have you? And this bit with the semiquavers, let's talk about what the best fingering is here. I think I'd probably go for a left hand E here, I think. On the right hand, I can play it with the right hand, but is it as good? I don't like it at the end of that bar if I do it with the right hand. I can play it, but I have to think about it a little bit more. Whereas the left hand, if I do a left hand bottom E with that one finger, I'm pretty fluent on that. I can play that nice and easy. So I think that's a left hand is the winner on that one. And then the next one, B, G, F. Are you going to do right hand F or left hand F? Don't really like the right hand one either on that one. The left hand, I find left hand F works a bit nicer for me there. you might find the right hand just plays slightly more evenly. I don't know, but I think I'd go left hand there again. And then the next one, 52, bar 52, is it? Yep. Similar pattern as to what we played previously, but with a B flat, not a C. Definitely a left hand on that one. So I'd go left hand on that one. And then the last one, I think this is the hardest one, isn't it? The D, A, F sharp. Now this is a bit nasty. I can't do left hand at all on this. I'm terrible at it. Left hand is nasty. So right hand F sharp, so I can move that fourth and fifth fingers together there. Unfortunately, I can just about play it at the right speed. So I go right hand on the F sharp there. Okay, moving on, we've got this cantabile section now. This is quite nice actually. So a chance to sort of get away from like the spiky stuff and the difficult stuff and just play a bit more legato and just kind of wash these dynamics in and out with your sound. Make sure you really use that accent. And then kind of just fade off in the distance there as you play the B to let the piano dum, 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 piano comes back in with the tune, like with the opening tune. I like this bit actually. So the piano goes da 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 dum dum bum, and you kind of pick up on the end of the piano's tune. So it's an easy entry to get right if you know that tune. So you carry straight on from the piano there, and it's a nice moment to just kind of play those bottom E's nice and quiet, but use that accent as kind of an extension of what the piano has just played. And really kind of just play it slightly more percussive, maybe like. And the dynamics are a bit difficult to do here, aren't they? So it says PP, and then you've got a bar to get to fortissimo. Quite hard to do and keep control of it all. You might have to just moderate the fortissimo a little bit. The PPs are easy enough. So big sound up there. That's quite tricky to do, I think, and keep control of all the notes. And then you're back to your sort of E minor fingering again. Again, practice this slowly, really. And then you've got the spiky semiquavers again. Notice quaver there, not semiquaver. Back to the semiquavers. Okay, right, again, another thing that I hear pupils play on this one. All sorts of stuff comes out. Again, don't practice it too quick. Too soon. Put the groundwork in. Maybe just stop on the E before you get to the, you know, as you get to the start of that seven group. So just do the four, the six. Or even just practice the six there. And then the seven. The seven can be, I think, a bit of a blur, can't it? Because you're just aiming for that top note. So practice the last two groups. But then stick the groups of four underneath that. And then you'll get there eventually. So just don't practice it too quick, too soon. And the last bit, great little ending to the movement, this actually. And not too difficult with the piano at all. You can kind of, it goes back into that 6-8-4-4 idea. last little bit of jazz there, kind of make a bit of a feature of that, I think. Last little moment there, not easy to kind of fit that in actually, is it? And make sure you're really precise with the tonguing on that last bar. So I think that's all I need to say on the detail of the music. I think just to summarize, make sure you practice the detail really slowly, put in the groundwork, as I've said, I think probably about 10 times on the video now. But it really is key on this piece. It's so easy to get to play very messy, this piece. And pupils, you know, if they practice it too quick, they come to play it with the piano, often don't get many rehearsals with the piano, and then just splat those, you know, difficult passages all over the place. So take the time to put in that groundwork, and then when you put under a bit of pressure, hopefully it will just kind of help you to stabilize the notes a little bit. So over to the piano accompaniments now. I have uploaded two versions of the piano accompaniment. There's the speed that I played at, which I have to say is quite difficult to play along with. And then there's a steady tempo one where I've inserted manually, rather painstakingly, I have to say, I've inserted clicks into those difficult parts just so that you can practice like with a metronome and the piano part, and just learn to play it sort of really in time with the piano. So best of luck with that. I'll see you on the next video. Bye.